Hi, I'm Mark Thomas, Solution Architect with Amazon Web Services. And today I'm here with Robbie Pocase from Canonical, Engineering Manager for the AWS Squad for Canonical Cloud. And we're going to talk about what it takes to bring Ubuntu Linux operating system images to EC2. Many of Amazon customers, AWS customers, use Ubuntu, LTS, and Ubuntu Pro on Amazon EC2 and take advantage of its long track record, celebrating 20 years of Ubuntu and many images, many releases, and just a long history of providing a secure, stable environment for users, both on and off the cloud. But what does it actually take to bring those images to you? And how do you know what all goes into that? How often are they released? Customers often want to know the details of what it is that they're betting their critical workloads on and the environment that they're building on. So Robbie's going to walk us through some of that.
Thank you, Mark. So while Ubuntu may be free to use, it's not free to distribute, and it requires quite a sophisticated pipeline to get delivered to the customers quickly and reliably. But we have two main sources that we use when we're building the images. First, we have the main package repository. This is the repository that kind of houses all the things that make Ubuntu Ubuntu. It's the repository that we guarantee long-term support around. And then we have the Snap Store, because when we build images for Amazon, we bundle at least one snap into it, and that's the AWS CLI, so that when you are using images on EC2, you can go ahead and interact with any of the APIs that Amazon provides. So we take these sources and we pack them into a root file system, and we start building everything that makes Ubuntu Ubuntu. So all the anything that you're typically familiar with was an Ubuntu server on top of a Amazon-specific cloud-optimized kernel that enables various cloud features such as Hibernation, and as well as enabling you to use all the different instance types that you're familiar with on AWS. Once that's built, we take a image and convert it into an Amazon machine image, and we go through and run that through a series of tests, because we want to not only provide you a secure operating system, we want to make sure that it is performant and free of regressions, and it supports all the different features that you're familiar with in the clouds, such as Hibernation and Secure Boot, but of course not limited to these features. So when we're testing for regressions, we're really testing to make sure that this image is really what you think of as Ubuntu. It's secure by default settings, such as only including the port 22 open, making sure cloud init works, so when you go to launch an image, you can apply all the customizations on top of it. And of course, making sure things like Hibernate and your secure boot work, so that you can apply certain attestations to your image at boot to make sure that all the packages you installed are ones that are compatible with your kernel. Assuming everything passes and across all the different instance types that we test against, as well as all the different regions that we're testing against, we publish that image across the remainder of the Amazon ecosystem. So we replicate to over 30 regions, and we also populate SSM parameters, or the systems manager. But before we do any publication, we ask a very important question. Is this actually a release candidate? Because while we start the build with, has any package or snap changed, not every package change is worth doing a release for. But if a critical package changes, such as the kernel or systemd or grub, or typically any package that requires a reboot on installation, we want to make sure that when you launch your instance, you don't have to reboot the instance as soon as it comes up. We want to make sure that we're shipping you a secure by default and ready to use image. And that's the build test publish pipeline for an image. And as you can, as Mark was mentioning, this goes across not just to the Ubuntu LTS for the architectures you're familiar with, like x86 and ORM, but across the wide fleet of images we support, like EKS and Amazon Workspaces.
So how often are these new images released on average?
Almost every single day. So we, just about every day, the main archives update. And when y'all release new versions of the AWS CLI, we start our pipeline, and this is not only across the latest LTS, but any other LTS that's being actively supported, or any Ubuntu releases that are in expanded security maintenance.
Okay, so with all of these images, how do I know that I'm running an official canonical produced Ubuntu image?
That's a great question. So we publicly document which account IDs are associated with ours, and you can verify that when you're looking at an AMI using the AWS CLI, using Describe Images, if it has a particular set of our particular account ID, you know it comes from us. On top of that, like I was saying, we have the SSM parameters. You can query against specific paths in SSM to find out what the AMI is for a particular region.
And the public parameters will also solve the problem of finding out what the latest image is if I want to know the absolute latest image to launch that has all of the existing security updates rolled up into that.
Yeah, absolutely.
And if you've come from a background where you're used to running Ubuntu on-premise, you're used to seeing releases like 22.04, 22.04.1, 22.04.5, how does that play into this process that you're doing here?
So we're always building from tip. Our versions don't map directly to a dot release. It's whatever is in the main archive at the time we build.
So it's just like with those dot releases, only a lot more frequently. You have all of the updates rolled up in there.
Yeah, absolutely.
And now Ubuntu Pro goes through the same kind of a process. Are there different things that are done to an Ubuntu Pro image, or does it have the same foundation that Ubuntu?
It's the exact same foundation. So anything that you expect from an LTS image, you have with a Pro image, but we also add a auto-attach package so that when you launch a Pro image, it'll auto-attach with the contract server, and now you can get all the entitlements that you expect with expanded security maintenance.
Okay, so in the words of Dr. Werner Vogels, everything breaks all the time. And you've taken a lot of steps here to make sure that an Ubuntu image is good and solid before you release it. What would happen if a AWS customer thinks that they have found a problem with the image and they want somebody to do something about that?
Sure, so you can go to our public bug tracker on Launchpad and file a bug against cloud images that flags to us that there might be a problem with an AWS image. From there, we coordinate with the appropriate teams within Canonical and make sure to get fixes extremely quickly. We have dedicated resources on the cloud teams to do this as well.
They can talk to Canonical directly on a Launchpad. The customers can also open an AWS support case, and there is a relationship between AWS and Canonical where we work very closely together on these issues and make sure that they're resolved quickly. Now, my last question, if there's a critical kernel security announcement that, hey, there's a zero-day bug in the kernel, the announcement happens, how do customers make sure that they're patched and current with all this? They've got a process, a pipeline that's launching new images. We talked about the public parameters, finding the latest image. Are those updated as soon as an image is released?
Yes, absolutely. As soon as we replicate to a region, the SSM parameter for that particular region is updated, and we take these CVEs extremely seriously. If you're familiar with the package release process, typically a package has to go through a baking process before it reaches main. For these kind of security features fixes, we're actually able to release to main very rapidly and often have a fix within the same day.
So very close to the time that a new kernel that is available for them to install Or if you're running Ubuntu Pro that is available to be fixed with a Ubuntu Live patch. There's a new Ubuntu LTS image very quickly after that, or Ubuntu Pro image that is available for them to launch from.
Yeah, that's a great point. If you're using Ubuntu Pro and with Live Patch, you'll get the kernel installed automatically through unattended upgrades, and you won't even have to reboot, and you're already patched and ready to go.
Thank you for taking the time to walk us through this. Robbie is directly managing the team that's responsible for all of this, and he can speak with authority on this process. So for Robbie Pocase, I'm Mark Thomas, Solution Architect, Amazon Web Services.